Jared Goff leads the first-place Rams into the Valley of the Sun. The Arizona Cardinals are fired up for a rematch in this NFC West showdown. We welcome you to University of Phoenix Stadium in Arizona and the NFL on Fox with three-time Super Bowl champ Darryl Johnston. I'm Chris Myers, and thanks for being with us. One of the great turnaround stories in the NFL continues. The Rams scoring 30 points a game, lead their division. Seattle on their heels, trying to win their ninth game. Now, coming up, they have the Eagles and the Seahawks. How do they play it today?
Well, one of the things that Sean McVay has been most impressed with his team about, and there's plenty for him to be impressed, is their ability to respond. A great example is last week, after losing to the Minnesota Vikings, coming back and beating one of the hottest teams in the NFL, the New Orleans Saints. You mentioned what's ahead of him. I think his big concern today is, does he have a mature team? This is a division opponent coming off a big win of their own against Jacksonville. How do they play this afternoon here?
And the Cardinals, they'll be without Adrian Peterson. He has a neck injury. Kerwin Williams in his spot. They're on their third-string quarterback. Blaine Gabbert has played well recently. They're hanging by a thread with some playoff hopes.
They really are. They've had injuries, and that impacts your margin of error during the course of the season. It's been running back by committee since they lost David Johnson earlier in the season. But you mentioned Blaine Gabbert, and he has done a nice job. He has added a spark. This has also been an offensive line that has had a lot of different starting combinations. I think the mobility of Blaine Gabbert gives him a better chance in the passing game. We'll see how he does this afternoon.
And the Cardinals have that earlier meeting on their mind when they were blanked 33-0. The youngest coach in the NFL against one of the senior members and 65-year-old Bruce Arians with Sean McVay. In fact, Sean McVay, the year he was born in 1986, Arians was in his third year as the head coach at Temple. And here's the playoff picture in the NFC as it stands to the moment, with the Falcons losing to the Vikings earlier, Green Bay keeping their playoff hopes alive with a win, the Lions losing to Baltimore. You see the Rams, Seattle playing later, and the Rams trying to maintain